Okay, good morning to all. I'm Mr. Khan. Welcome in Mr. Khan Academy. Today I'm going to cover the third part of 3.1.2 components of pneumatic system. Already the first two part I covered in my channel, that is the 3.1.2 part 1 air generation distribution and part 2 valves and processing element. These two video links are available on my channel, or you can check the link on me this card icon or description box. Today I am going to cover the power components and system. This is the last two parts on the components of pneumatic system. Before starting this video, I request to all my viewers, you can visit my channel. If you want to check my channel, for that purpose you need to type www.youtube.com/MrKhanAcademy and press enter. In taskbar, you need to type www.youtube.com/MrKhanAcademy, and if you press the enter, you will visit on my channel. This is the my channel, Mr. Khan Academy. Here you will get the video lecture on various various topic on the mechatronic subject. Like this is the introductory lecture of mechatronic, that is series 1, on which I cover the key limits of mechatronics, application of mechatronics, basic component of mechatronics, design procedure, and electrical actuation system, that is series 2, in which DC motor, stepper motor, AC induction motor, voice coil actuators are available. And just recently I started the series 3.1, in which already I covered the three video characteristics and application of pneumatic and component of pneumatic system part 1 and part 2. And today I'm going to cover the part 3. And don't forget to hit the subscribe my channel. If you subscribe my channel, you will get the notification whenever I'm going to upload any video related with the mechatronics. Okay, let's start with the content. The topics I'm going to cover in the series 3.1. Already I covered, as I said, 3.1.1 and part 1 and part 2 of 3.1.2, air generation system and processing element and wall and processing element. And today I'm going to cover the power component and system. And in future I'm going to cover the symbols and standards in pneumatic, method of development pneumatic system, and various cycle, single acting and multi actuator circuits. If you want the notification of all this video, future video, in that purpose you need to hit the subscribe my channel. Please the hit like button if you like my video in future, whatever I'm explaining, and share this video with your friends also. Let's start with the content. Power components. What exactly is a power component? The power section consists of control element and power component. The power section consists of a control element and power component, that it is also called as a actuator. The what exactly that means, the signal flow of pneumatic system, already I explained in 3.1.1. I'm not going to explain this thing once again. You need to check my this video in which I explain how the signal flow from hot to up, okay, the flow of the signal, in which the last two step, the control element, power component, that I'm talking about, that is power section, and in which the power component, that actuator we are using. The actuator group includes various type of actuator, that is a linear and rotary, that we are going to explain in next slide, and they are varying according to size and construction. The actuator are complemented by the control element, which transfer the required quantity of air to the drive actuator. Means with actuator we are getting the control element also, the combine. This is the product that I'm asking, the power section, in which this is the power component, piston cylinder, single acting or double acting cylinder, and this is a control element, the combined use actuator with the control element, that I am talking. The actuator are complemented with the control element, which transfer the required quantity of air to drive the actuator. Might be forward stroke, reverse stroke, that we are controlling with the help of control element. Normally this valve will be directly connected to the main air supply and fitted close to the actuator to minimize the losses due to the resistance. This is all about the power component. Let's see the type of the power component. The power component divided into the following groups: the linear actuator, that is a single acting cylinder or double acting cylinder. What is a single acting cylinder and what is double acting cylinder, that we are going to cover in the at the time of systems in following beats, that I'm going to cover in this video lecture. And rotary actuator, that is air motor and rotary actuator. If you want to linear motion, then we are using the linear actuator. If you want the rotary motion, then we are using the air motor and rotary actuators. Let's start with the system, second part of this video lecture. What exactly the system? Generally, the actuation of the cylinder is affected via the direction control valve. Means if suppose any cylinder, if you want to use for that purpose, you need to select a proper direction control valve. The choice of such direction control valve is dependent on the respective application. Means whatever the direction control valve we are selecting, it might be depends on number of connection, number of switching position, type of actuation. It's totally based on exactly what is the application where we want to implement the direction control one. What I want to say, let's see the example. Let's suppose I want to control the circuit for the single acting cylinder. Suppose I want to use the direction control valve for the single acting cylinder. Then what is a single acting cylinder? Piston of the single acting cylinder is advanced when the push button is operated. Suppose I press the push button, then piston rod will be advances, it moves the forward direction. And when push button is released, the piston is automatically returned to initial position. Means here when it's reverse, when I'm releasing the push button, then it's come to this original position in reverse direction because of spring back effect, not because of pneumatic force, not because of air force, pressurized air, compressed air. It is come back with the spring effect. Because of that, it's called a single acting cylinder. Only forward direction we are controlling with the help of compressed air, plus reverse direction we are getting with the help of spring. Okay, let's see with the type of diagram. This is a diagram, and this is called as a single acting cylinder. Just see here, the spring is there. If I'm supplying the compressed air, it moves forward direction, and when I'm releasing this push button, when I'm releasing push button again, this is a wall. It's called as a 3x2 wall. Why it's called a 3x2? Because three port, one is a supply port, one is a single output force, and this is exhaust port, three port, and this is square box indicate the position, three position. It looked like a three box, three squares, but this is the part of casing I can say in which spring is attached. But wall is only whatever the color is showed over here. This is the wall, and two position, three port, because of the color 3x2 port, 3x2 wall, direction control wall. In single acting cylinder, we are using the 3x2 direction control wall. Okay, when I'm, this is the initial position, I'm not pressing anything. That time, whatever the air is there, it leaving from the exhaust, and we are stopping the supply port. And when I'm pressing this push button, then it's come to this connected position, and this line is connected with this line. Just see, and a compressed air is supply, and we are getting the forward direction. Might be you're confused, you're not getting what I'm explaining. Then just see with the help of that animation. Fluid sim software, pneumatic. Okay, this is the same thing, the connected 3x2 direction control wall. There is schematic view is there. This is a symbolic representation. Okay, right now it is a disengaged position. Then whatever the air is there, it is exhausting from here, and the supply is not connected. This is a it's called as a FRL, filter, regulate, lubricate. Okay, lubrication is not here, only filter and regulate is there. And this is a supply source. And what exactly is this? Already I covered in the previous video. You can check over there. Now let's actuate the signal. Now just when I'm pressing the supply play button, the compressed air is passed from here to here, but it is stopped. It is not passing over here because it is disconnected. When I'm pressing this button, just see, then this, it will be connected, and the compressed air is passed over here, and I'm getting the forward direction. Okay, when I'm releasing it, it will be disengaged, and it will be put again initial position. When I'm pressing, it will be forward direction, releasing reverse direction. This is all about the circuit of single acting cylinder. Okay, control circuit of single acting cylinder. For that purpose, I need to use the 3x2 direction controller. Now let's see the control circuit of double acting cylinder. Now I'm changing this actuating cylinder. Instead of single acting, I'm doing the double acting. The same thing here also we are doing. The piston rod double acting cylinder is advances when push button is operated and return to its initial position when push button is released. Same thing whatever we are doing the previous thing. This only difference is that in previous one and this one, we cannot use the 3x2 direction control wall over here, because as I said in a first slide of the system, the direction control wall we need to choose according to application. Then here also the application different. I want to control the double acting cylinder, then I cannot use 3x2 direction control wall. The double acting cylinder can carry out the work in both direction of motion due to the full air supply pressure being available for extension and retraction. Means here the supply air is on both the side. In the previous case, reverse direction is because of spring back, spring force, but here also the reverse direction because of compressed air. Let's see the circuit diagram, then you come to know that what exactly I want to say. This is circuit diagram of control circuit for double acting cylinder. Now here, the control wall, this is a direction control wall. Here just see the ports are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, 5 ports are there and 2 position. This is 5x2 control wall. And previously in the single acting cylinder, we are using 3x2 control wall. As I said, we need to select the direction control wall according to application. Here the application is different. Here we are using the double acting cylinder. The wall required here will be the 5x2 control wall. In the previous case, as we are using the single acting cylinder, we need to use 3x2 control wall. This is all about the circuit. This is the initial position. Right now, the compressed air is supplied from supply port to the we can say backward direction of this piston, and in a forward direction, whatever the air is, it is exhausting. And when I'm pressing this push button, then this position will be linked over here, okay? And because of that, where I'm getting the exhaust from, there I'm supplying now air, okay? And we are getting the forward stroke, and from the backside we are getting exhaust. Might be confused, you are not getting exactly what I want to say. Let's see the circuit diagram, then you will come to know that exactly what I want to say. This is a circuit diagram, okay? Same sub source is there. This is a filter and regulator, and this is a 5x2 control wall, and this is double acting cylinder. The connection will be like this. Right now we are supplying the port number 1 supply port to the port number 2, and 4 we are connected with the exhaust. 3 is the empty, 3 only connect when I am pressing the push button. Let's play this circuit. Now see, the compressed air is passed from here, from port number 1 to 2, and from here, that nothing is changed. This is the initial position. When I am adding the push position, now the wall is pushed from here, and compressed air is now instead of 1 to 2, it's supplying 1 to 4, and I'm getting the forward stroke. When I'm releasing this, I'm getting the reverse stroke. This is all about the double acting cylinder. When I'm pressing, I'm getting forward stroke, I'm releasing reverse stroke. Same thing, but as the actual the power components change, the direction control wall is changed. This is all about the system I want to explain. If you want to understand more what I am explaining, for that purpose you can refer the Fundamental of Pneumatic Festo series. Other books also available. I am strongly recommending this book, because whatever the content I am preparing over here on this slide, yeah, in this video lecture, I am taking from Fundamental of Pneumatic Festo series only. Okay, thank you very much for watching this video. You can check my first series. This is the third series. You can check my first series, Introduction to Mechatronics, and the second series, Electrical Actuating System, which is available on my channel as I explained, or you can check on this card icon as well as in description box also. And please don't forget to hit the subscribe my channel, to subscribe my channel to motivate me to make a such video in future also. Hit like button, share this video with your friends also, and don't forget to hit the subscribe my channel to get the notification. Thank you very much. See you soon. Bye bye. Take care.